We're here in sunny Scottsdale, Arizona with Fox Factory, checking out their newest suspension and rallying some trucks in the desert.
What you thought when Fox asked you to use your bike?
Yeah, it's exactly what I had in mind. Jumping some pickup truck.
Earlier this winter, Fox invited us down to Scottsdale, Arizona to get a sneak peek at upcoming products. Before we could see the latest and greatest in mountain bike suspension, Fox treated us to a real Arizona welcome. First, we rallied around the desert in side-by-sides equipped with Fox's legendary automotive suspension. Then they took us to participate in a true Arizonian tradition, Top Golf. And let me tell you, mountain bikers are fantastic golfers. Finally, we were wined and dined at the finest eating and entertainment establishment in Scottsdale, Medieval Times, which was conveniently located across the parking lot from the Fox offices. But let's be honest, you didn't come here to watch us golf or eat turkey legs at a jousting tournament. You came here to find out about the latest products from Fox, and we are going to dive into the all-new Fox 36. Last year, we saw the introduction of the GripX and GripX2 dampers, but no changes to the chassis of the 36. Well, this year, it's all about chassis updates and reducing friction. We were lucky enough to chat with Tom Pollock, the lead engineer on the new 36 project, and have him run us through this year's updates. So let's get into it. Tom, we talked with you last year about the new transfer dropper post. Yep. And this year we are talking about new 36. Super exciting. We kind of got the whole presentation of these forks, but maybe run us through what is new on 36. There's a bunch of cool stuff in here.
We focused on a few things. We wanted to make the fork stiffer, we wanted to make it smoother, and we were not going to add any weight. So first up, upper tubes get a little bit longer with that. The bushing in the lower leg moves down, we get more bushing overlap. That helps reduce friction. With a longer upper tube, we can make a better air spring. So, two changes there. Got an all new lower leg. Pretty cool look here. The most visually obvious feature you see is the windows there. But we spent a lot of time on this arch, and our engineering team is really invested in using a generative design tool and really upped their skills with that tool. And turn that into something that's cool. This is where a lot of our benefits come for the torsional stiffness, but again, without adding any weight.
Yeah, you kind of mentioned your team uses a generative program. Yep. Kind of, you guys are using AI. We're in the future here. It's like ChatGPT for bike stuff. How does the team work with that technology to create these new forks?
It's a good question. It's a design tool. So the tool will answer the question you ask it, is how I kind of like to phrase it. And our team has gotten really good at asking the right questions. So. Their job is to set up the right space in which it can suggest a shape, give it the right targets. If they don't give it the right inputs, the tool will give an answer, but that answer is not useful. So the team's work on the front end is really important. On the back end, they take the answer that it gives, which is just a suggestion, and it's not something you could actually make, and then they turn that into a product you could actually make.
Sounds like kind of a lot of time to go from prompting it, getting the design, and then really making it. So
absolutely, yeah, it's a good tool, but it doesn't do the work by itself by any means. Our team and Dan McCormick was the engineer and our expert in that, and he did an excellent job with that.
Sweet. Some other new features we're still running, GripX and GripX2 dampers in the 36, but new air springs.
Yeah.
Scott, you wanna hit on what is happening in the air spring on the new
Definitely. Course. So the air spring came from a few years ago, actually. Our head of engineering challenged our engineering team, said we've gotta make the best feeling, lowest friction forks that we can make, and that's happening for model year 26. So the team set out to work on a lot of different areas. Sam Schaefer worked on the air spring and came up with something really cool. So when the fork's being loaded, there's forces that are trying to side load this air piston inside the stanchion, and also trying to side load the air shaft as it passes through this neg plate. And so we built in some compliance that allows those two to move. And that allows these parts to stay perfectly aligned with the bushings and seals, given the minimum amount of friction. The most beneficial thing about it is it works best when the loads are highest. And that's the time when, without this, you might feel some additional friction. When those loads are highest, it's when you're stuffing it into a berm. It's when you need the most traction. And that's when it works the best to keep your fork active and keep your tire glued to the ground.
Cool. And then just kind of simple updates that you guys made. Volume spacers, everybody should play around with those.
Yes.
It's important to do that.
Yes.
It's now a Shimano cassette lock ring tool to get that off. So that's definitely a sweet feature. Tom, want to say a thanks?
Yeah.
Do a great job of running us through this stuff. I have the 36 on my bike. Definitely excited to get out and ride it today.
Sweet.
So, sweet.
Appreciate
thanks
it.
Thanks again.
Definitely not something we encounter in Bellingham. Usually the pine cones are a little less prickly.
We are finally out on the trail doing what we came here for, riding the new Fox 36 to see how it compares to the previous years. We have traded the grip and loam of the Pacific Northwest and the pine trees for cactuses and kitty litter dirt. So we're gonna get out on the trail and see what these forks are all about. The team at Fox claims these forks are 20% stiffer and you can push them harder than you could before. So we're gonna ride, see if I can find some grip in the corners and have a good time. So let's go. Definitely not in the Pacific Northwest. Mad respect to those people that ride out here all the time and go fast. This Fox, new Fox stuff, this 36 in particular, great kind of trail fork. Let your mob, not too heavy, nice and stiff to support you when you need it. Woo! Woo! Got some jumps here in the desert. There definitely isn't much of a landing, kind of a splat to flat, so maybe somewhere where you crank up some high-speed compression, get yourself a little more support when you go splat. Huge thanks to Fox for having us out to Arizona this winter. They treated us like royalty, taking us to medieval times, and got our bike styled in with the new suspension. Now we are back in Bellingham, and it is the classic soaking wet PNW winter. Despite the constant drizzle, I have luckily been able to put some miles on the new 36 and have some thoughts. And let me tell you, I think this is the year of Fox suspension. So what are the big takeaways with the new Fox 36? I think there are three main things that Fox was focusing on. One was a reduction in friction, two was their new compliant air springs, and three was the updated chassis stiffness. First up was reducing the friction in the system. And how did they accomplish that? That was by increasing the bushing overlap. Now, when you say increasing bushing overlap, you probably think some overlapping bushings, but really what it means is they have spread out the bushings in this fork to reduce the friction between the upper stanchion and the lower legs, leading to a smoother ride for you out on the trail. The second major update was the updated compliant air springs. Now Fox is cleverly using little bits of rubber in the air spring to help mitigate those bending forces that your fork is going to encounter when you're running headfirst into rocks and roots and things like that. That new compliant air spring has a little bit of movement to it so that even when things are misaligned when you're making those impacts, it's still gonna keep everything moving smoothly. Regarding air springs, I do want to briefly touch on the travel ranges that the new Fox 36 will be available in. Out of the box, you will find the 36 in a 150 and a 160 configuration,
but there will be aftermarket air springs available, and you can get them down to 140 millimeters on the new Fox 36. If you're looking for a longer travel fork, you're obviously going to be looking at the Fox 38. And for those aggressive trail bike riders who want a slightly lighter weight package than this 36, there is the all new 36 SL, which will be available for 120, 130, and 140 millimeter travel options. We are hoping to get our hands on one of those forks and give you our thoughts on it later on down the road, so stay tuned for that. The final takeaway, and the biggest one that I think people are going to notice on the new 36, is the chassis stiffness. Now, when comparing the new 36 to the previous generation, Fox is claiming a 20% increase in torsional stiffness on this fork. If you're like me, you're probably one of those people who often thinks about overforking their trail bike, and I had been contemplating a 160-38 on my Forbidden Druid because I just wanted that extra stiffness and confidence when the trail gets rough. But with that big 38 mil stanchion fork, there's definitely a weight penalty you're going to be paying. After riding the new Fox 36, I think that this is the perfect fork for that aggressive trail bike rider who used to overfork their bike. You no longer have to overfork it because this thing is 87% of the torsional stiffness of a Fox 38, but again, you get the weight savings of a 36. So, for the aggressive trail bike rider, I think the new 36 is a must have. Seriously, I have been blown away by the new Fox 36. If you have any questions about the new Fox suspension, throw them in the comments below and we will do our best to answer them. And of course, if you want to shop the new Fox 36 and other Fox suspension, you can find that at fanaticbike.com. Once again, I want to say thanks to Fox for having us out to Arizona this winter and getting our bikes kitted out with the new suspension. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to go put this back on my bike so I can ride it some more. I want to thank you for watching, and we'll see you out on the trails.